Hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're covering a new solution that's dropped to improve fixing hands, something that continues to plague many Stable Diffusion images. You can see here in this example that I've provided how the hands flow from the initial generation and how they improve with each step. Now, this image over here on the left is actually a pretty good starting point. The left hand is actually perfect. However, if you look at the right hand, we are missing a finger. This is something that's fixed in the final image if we look over here on the right. And in fact, the hand that already was fine looks even better with certain depth applied to it. This technique is not perfect and it does have a lot of room for improvement. And I actually do want to try combining it with the face replacer covered in this video over here. Now, if you want to know how that turns out and get access to advanced workflows, please sign up for my newsletter or check out the Patreon, where I talk about the latest in AI news and have exclusive resources for people subscribed or joining the Patreon. It also really helps the channel out, and it's a fantastic way for you to support what we're doing here. Now, jumping right in to get moving with this technique, there are two things that we need to download and make sure that you have before getting started. The first is the ComfyUI ControlNet Auxiliary Preprocessors. You can find it over here in Managers. Go into Install Custom Nodes and look up Fanovel 16. And you'll find the nodes right here, ComfyUI's ControlNet Auxiliary Preprocessors. You'll note this is also the same creator that we used in this ControlNet video that had created a bunch of nodes and preprocessors specifically for ControlNet. Now, I mentioned that because this is a new version of his node collection. And if you have the old one installed, please uninstall it, as having that one and this one installed at the same time will cause issues. I do also want to mention that I've personally experienced issues with this node collection right here, the Cosyncadink Comfy Advanced ControlNet. I do have this installed on my cloud machine, and I was not able to see the auxiliary preprocessors while having this installed. The other file you need to download is this one over here, Control-SD15 InPaint Hand Depth. And this will work with a Stable Diffusion 1.5 model. So go ahead and download that. And once you've downloaded it, you need to place it in your ComfyUI directory in the Models folder right here, and then inside ControlNet. And once that's done, you are ready to rock and roll. So if we look at the workflow, it might seem like there's a lot going on, but don't worry, I got you guys. It's actually a lot simpler than it seems. So let's go through it. Oh, and by the way, if you want to access this particular workflow, it's available for everyone to download, links in the description below. So if we start at this kind of global overview, you can see that we have the workflow split into a few key areas. Number one, the first key area is over here on the left, and this is what I'll call the base generation. This is just a standard Stable Diffusion 1.5 generation with standard prompts. Then over here in section number two, we have the ControlNet auxiliary setup, those nodes that we saw earlier. And here we are just finding the hands and using a depth map to define them. Over here on the third part, we are simply regenerating the hands on the existing image that we created earlier. And then here in the fourth part, all we have is a latent upscale that upscales the image and redoes parts of it to give it a little bit more clarity. And then finally, down here at the bottom in this green group is simply the output of each step so that we can compare the image from beginning to end. And that's pretty much it. Really easy, as you guys can see. And to make things even better, I've actually gone into the workflow and made notes for you guys. So once you download it, you can see explanations of what each section does. I take care of you guys. And finally, this section up here that you might have noticed, this is just an organizational technique that I picked up from a game called Factorio, if you know, you know, that I call the bus. It's simply a way to just organize nodes and strings of information to make sure that everything stays nice and tidy. So now that you have an overview, let's dive a little deeper into what's happening. And before I forget, if you're finding this at all helpful, please don't forget to like and subscribe for more content and press the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release new videos. So if we jump closely into the second group called hand masking and refinement, the star of the show is this mesh graph former right here. And what this is it's actually very similar to the face replacer from this video up here. And all it does is it takes the image generated from the base refiner, it looks for the hands, and then it creates a depth map for them. From the depth map, it then creates a mask. What's really interesting is if you look very closely at the depth map, it's actually already fixed the problematic hand with all five fingers. So the way that it works is it takes the image, it looks for the hands, it fixes the hands based on what looks like maybe a 3D model that it then turns into a depth map. So it always knows that there needs to be five fingers. And then once it has that depth map, it also creates a mask, which is what we will use for in painting in the next section. That's all this section does. Really easy. And as usual, I have a little explainer right over here. We then pass the mask that we've just generated into the apply control net as the image right over here. In addition to that, we are also plugging in the load control net model that we downloaded earlier, the control stable diffusion 1.5 in paint depth hand. And then finally, we're also plugging in our positive and negative prompts, which we can see coming up here through the bus from the original prompts. This is one area that we can mess around with, and we will experiment with this later on in the video. At this time, I'm just using the original prompts that I created. However, you could create empty prompt boxes, or you could add on prompts that are specific to hands, or you could even take those original prompts as we've done here, append them with additional information specific to the hands, and plug them all into the control net. Mileage may vary, results may vary. We are going to try a few of those in a bit, but I'd love to hear from you what you've tried and what works for you. Now, the important thing to note is at this point, all we've done is tell the control net and the inpainter what needs to be inpainted, but we haven't actually fed that to the case sampler. So the important step here is we need to also apply the mask to the latent. And that's what this little node over here does. Set latent noise mask. What this does is it takes the latent from the previously generated image, and it also applies the mask. You can see here the green line going in here. It combines these two to create a masked latent, which we then feed into the case sampler, and now it knows only to generate on the hands. From here, the latent is spit out into the Ve decoder, where we get a save of the image as well as a preview. And you'll see again, immediately after decoding it, we are encoding it once again. And the reason for that is we need to remove the mask from the hands for the next step of the generation, where we are upscaling the whole image. If we don't do this, only the hands or the masked area will be upscaled. And again, I have that explained over here. Once we convert it back into a latent, and before we upscale it, we are passing it through ControlNet one more time. And this is another area where we can vary a little bit what we're doing. In this particular example, we are loading in a regular stable diffusion depth control net, which you can see here, and we are plugging that into the apply control net. From image, we are actually taking the generated image over here with the hands, which you can see it's actually gotten a little bit worse from the base image. The left one's got a little bit more distortion. However, the right one now has all the fingers. And looking at the artifacts that we have here, that might have been cleaned up a little bit more if we had put it through a few more steps, but whatever, we'll work with what we've got. So we are turning this entire image into a depth map using the Midas depth map over here. We then plug that into the apply control net. So the apply control net is getting the depth control net, the depth map from the Midas, and once again, receiving the positive conditioning only from the original prompt. Again, this is an opportunity to put in a different prompt, a blank prompt, and see what results you get. Now, the important thing to note is in this particular group here, we are just setting up the control net. The ultimate output of this is this one little conditioning here, which takes all of that control net data and pushes it into the positive parameter of this final case sampler. The other things that go into this case sampler is the latent from the second group, which is this group over here. So this output is getting fed in as a latent after having the mask removed into this node over here, which upscales the latent by 1.5x. and feeds that into the case sampler. We have the standard negative prompt, which is coming from all the way from the original negative prompt. And finally, we have the original model being fed in as well. All of this combines to regenerate the image entirely based with all of the information that we fed it in at an upscaled level to end up with this final result. And you'll notice if we come here at the end, that there are many aspects of the image that are the same pose, the same characteristics of the character, but you'll see there is a big difference in the details from the second to the third image. And that is because we are regenerating the whole image as we upscale it. Now wait, don't go just yet. We still have a few more tips and tricks and variations that we need to go through that can help improve or affect your image. One of the key parameters that you can tweak to improve your hand generation is over here in the mesh graph former. You want to play around with mask expand. I had some issues with some hands that I generated earlier with the default settings, which came at an 8. I brought it down to a 7, which worked really well for the slender hands of this character. Go ahead and increase it or decrease it depending on the size of the hand, and you will get varied results. On that note, I have experienced that full body images on Stable Diffusion 1.5 do not perform well, and that is because the original hand that is being created is already very deformed at that small size that it's just not able to make it work at such a small size. You may get better results on Stable Diffusion XL as the pixels available are overall more. However, I'm unable to test that on this machine. If you want to know how that turns out, once again, check out the newsletter. I will be posting updates to the website on the blog. Now, there is one more tip worth mentioning, and that is over here in mask type under the mesh graph morpher. You can actually go in and select whether you want your mask based on depth, tight boxes, or original. You can see here when I put it to tight boxes, the mask becomes boxes. Use this at your own risk. You will get mixed results because you are ultimately giving Stable Diffusion more room to try and generate the hands. Depending on your model and your prompt, you may get better results, you may get worse results. Again, I think this will probably work better on SDXL, but for reference, I threw in the boxes. I also threw in these prompts specific to the control net. And while the right hand looks great, the left hand now has too many fingers. So mileage may vary. And that, my friends, is an overview of this brand spanking new hand fixing technique for January 2024. I'm sure as time goes on, these techniques are just going to get better and better. Don't forget to stay tuned, like and subscribe to know when the next technique becomes available. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I hope this video was really helpful for you guys. I'll catch you on the next one.